Hello student, welcome once again in our fourth session of lesson A Gift of Chappals. Yes, you heard really right. It is a gift of chappals. We have seen that how children were actually eager to give that chappals to that beggar, and are they really successful to give him a very nice pair of chappal? Let's see what happened next in the next session. Look at this para. I don't know, said Ravi. Mine are too small. Means we have seen that here Mrudu asked Ravi, is there any pair of chappals in your house somewhere? And Mrudu replied over that, I don't know, said Ravi. Mine are too small. And he again pointed out there that mine chappals are very small and to fit that beggar's feet. I would have given them to him, and his feet were larger than Mrudu's and Meena's. And here I would have given them to him, and his feet were larger than Mrudu's and Meena's. And Meena's and Mrudu's feet were also very smaller than beggar's feet, and therefore they also not giving him their chappals. The beggar was shaking out his upper clothes and tightening his dhoti. He raised his eyes and looked fearfully at the road gleaming in the afternoon heat. Then what happened? The beggar was shaking out of his upper clothes and tightening his dhoti. Means he was getting ready to go out from that neem tree. He raised his eyes and looked fearfully at the road, because as he want to go out from that, because Ravi told him that go away from there, from here, and therefore he was worried because there are that pink peeling blisters are there at his bare feet, and therefore he was so much worried about that. And because there is a huge heat at that afternoon, let's see what happened next. He needs something on his feet, Meena said, her big eyes feeling it's not fair. What happened? Then Meena replied, he needs something maybe for his feet, and then it's not fair to tell him to go go in that heat or afternoon that tar roads. Okay, shh, said Ravi, I am thinking about it. Hey, wait, why are you talking like this? I am thinking about it, blubbering, it's not fair, it's not fair. And he talked like that, it's not fair, it's not fair. Isn't going to help. In 2 minutes he will be frying his feet on that road. What he needs is a pair of chappals. So where do we get them? Come, let's search the house. He pushed Mrudu and Meena into the house, and they think over it. In 2 minutes he will be frying his feet on that road. Here Ravi said that within 2 minutes his legs may be fried out, and therefore what he needs is only pair of chappals. So where do we get that chappals? Let's see, let's search in the house. He pushed Mrudu and Meena into the house to search out the pair of chappals. Then just as she stepped into the veranda, Mrudu's eyes fell on the odd looking chappals she had noticed when she arrived. But as they went to the veranda, Mrudu found that there is an old looking chappals in the veranda, and she had noticed that when she arrived at Ravi's house Ravi's veranda, like that. Okay, and she whispered to Ravi that, whose are those? Hey Ravi, whose are those chappals? Okay, Ravi turned and glanced at the shabby looking but sturdy old slippers. Then that Ravi also went there He saw that shabby looking chappals, but sturdy. Sturdy means that used by that strong built man. Okay, like that. That sturdy and old slippers. He beamed and nodded. Means he sign out to the Mrudu. These are just right size. She noticed that size of chappals is very perfect for that beggar, and they are just right size, he said. Picking them up, Mrudu and Meena followed him nervously back into the garden, and they all picked that pair of chappals, and that three children went to the garden where the beggar was. Okay, next page, let's see what happened. Here, said Ravi to the beggar, dropping the slippers in front of the old man, and he dropped that pair of slippers in front of the old beggar. Wear this and don't come back. He told that beggar, hey, wear this and don't come back. The beggar stared at the slippers. Beggar stared means look at that slipper. Hurriedly flung his towel over his shoulder, pushed his feet into them and left, muttering and blessing to the children. In a minute, he had vanished around the corner of the street. Look at that lines. And when Ravi dropped that slipper in front of the old man and told him that, wear this and don't come back, the beggar stared at that slipper. Immediately, beggar stared at that slipper, hurriedly flung his towel, means hurriedly take off his towel on his shoulder, push his feet into them, means he wear that chappal immediately, and muttering and bless to the children. In a minute, he had vanished around the corner of the street, and he immediately went off to that garden by wearing that chappals. Then suddenly what happened? The music master came out of the house and took an unappreciative look at that three of them sitting quietly under the tree playing marbles. Look at that. And within that time, what happened? The music master that came out of the house and took an unappreciative look at the three of them, which sitting quietly under the tree playing marble. Unappreciative means disapproving. What they are playing like that? He looked within that three children. Then he searched for his chappal in the veranda where he had put them. And then what happened? It's a funny thing. Look at that. Then he searched for his chappal in the veranda where he had put them. He called. Let's see. Lalli, he called. After a few moments, she hurried up to him. Have you seen my chappals, my dear? I remember having kept them here. He asked Lalli, hey Lalli, come here. Have you seen my chappals, my dear? I remember I kept my chappal, pair of chappal in veranda. Ravi, Mrudu and Meena silently watched Lalli and the music master search every corner of the veranda. Now see what happened. Ravi, Mrudu and Meena silently watched Lalli and music master. Okay. And they, how they are searching here and there. Okay, like that. He scurried around, looking over the railing and crouching near the flower pots to look between them. Means that Lalli and music master, they are looking over and railing and crouching near the flower pots. Means they look near the flower pots and they search out the chappals, but they didn't find it out. Brand new they were. I went all the way to Mount Road to buy them. He went on saying, they cost a whole month's fees, do you know? Here, that music master told Lalli that, hey Lalli, it's a brand new, and I went to purchase it to Mount Road, okay? And the cost of that chappals was actually a whole month's fees, do you know? Then, see what happened. Soon, Lalli went and tell to her mother. But suddenly, Lalli went to her mother to tell about that slipper. Rukmini appeared looking harassed with Patti following her. As Lalli told her mother about the chappal, then Rukmini came there, looked harassed, and Patti followed her. Then where could they be? It's really quite upsetting to think someone might have stolen them. So many vendors come to the door, worried Patti. So many vendors come to the door, worried Patti. Here, when Rukmini came, she talked like that, where could they be? Where are that slippers or that chappals? It's really quite upsetting. It is not a good thing to think someone might have stolen, if somebody has stolen that chappals. It is very bad thing. And Patti worried about that. So many vendors come to the door. Many of people came to us, and therefore, we don't know what happened about your chappals. Then Rukmini caught sight of Ravi, Mridu and Meena sitting under the tree. But suddenly, Rukmini gazed, means caught, that side, Ravi and Mridu and Meena sitting under the tree. Have you children? Have you seen that chappal? She began there, and then seeing they were curiously quiet, went on more slowly. Seen anyone lurking around the veranda? And then she asked, when she saw all the three children were very curious and quiet, she went on to them and asked, have you seen it in veranda, that chappals of music master? Okay, let's see what happened next. A sharp V-shaped line and had formed between her eyebrows. And she formed that V-shaped line had formed between her eyebrows, means she was very annoyed or angry. Another straight, tighter one appeared in place of her usually soft, pleasant mouth. And she was actually annoyed. But Rukmini was very angry, thought Mridu with a shiver. And Mridu was very afraid when she saw Rukmini's face like that. She wouldn't be so upset if she knew about the poor beggar with sores on his feet, she tried to tell herself. And she wouldn't be so upset if she knew about the poor beggar with the sores on his feet, she tried to tell herself. It means what? She was very actually upset as she saw that poor beggar and their feet. And therefore, she tried to tell herself. Taking a look at that, taking a deep breath, she cried. Means Mridu tried, starts crying. Rukmini, there was a beggar here. Poor thing, he had such a boils on his feet. And she told her auntie that, hey aunt, there was a poor beggar here and he had such a boils on his feet. So Rukmini said grimly, so, what happened? What about that beggar? Rukmini said very grimly, turning to the Ravi, you gave the music master chappals to that old beggar who turned up here? And she suddenly asked Ravi that, hey Ravi, have you give that music master chappals to that old beggar wood turnips here, like that. And then the whole story took place. Students, we will see whole next part in our next session. Okay, student? So, thank you for hearing me. Thank you so much.